What's up, everybody? It's the Bearded Shark, but you already know that. And today we're going to be talking about an oil that I've been using for the past 6 weeks. And you guys have been messaging me on Instagram, which if you don't follow my Instagram, are you living under a rock or something? Because you should be following me on Instagram. It's the official Bearded Shark. I'll put it in the description below so you guys can follow me. But today we're going to talk about my experience with using a beard growth oil. Now, I chose this one for a reason because I've seen the ingredients on there, and actually the owner sent it out to me as a package that I ordered as just a sample. And then I was like, you know, everybody talks about growth oils and all that, so I wanted to try it out. So he sent me this, which you guys can see, it's pretty much empty. And then I have this one right here, which this one is pretty much full. So this and this together. So, I mean, like, you know, I haven't got to this, but I use all this right here. So beard growth oil, a lot of people ranting and raving about it, how it's a myth, how it's a gimmick, it's a scam for people. And most of the beard oils, growth oils that I've seen out there is a scam and a gimmick. And it's mainly, you'll see ingredients that you find in regular beard oils that you get at Walmart or at your drugstore or from companies that we enjoy using on a day-to-day basis. So I'm not going to go over every single ingredient that is in this beard oil because I don't think that would be fair for the bearded pup, because of the simple fact that I don't want a company to go and mimic the same product that they have. It's not fair. So if you guys want to know about every exact ingredient that's in his grow oil, I'll just put his Instagram panhandle in the bottom, so in the description below, so you guys can message him. So today I'm going to talk about five different ingredients, and then we'll go from there. You know, so if you guys seen my thumbnail on here, and then also you can look right up there, you'll see the before and after picture of me using the beard oil and the dates that I've used it. Sorry, it is a little bit past 6 weeks, but life happens, and I was focusing on, you know, school and, you know, life. You know, I had to be an adult, guys. You know, sometimes you have to be an adult. And so let's go ahead and get started, and I'll give you guys my final thoughts about the beard oil itself. So I'm going to start off with the most popular ingredient that everybody talks about or one of the most popular ingredients that you find in the supermarket or your vitamin store or just a drugstore, and that's biotin. Biotin is known to help people grow facial hair, head hair. It's great for skin and nails as well. Most people that use biotin, they come back and say, I'm starting to grow hair some places I didn't even know that even existed. And their fingernails just, you know, skyrocket and they start growing quickly. And, you know, they have to cut them quickly. But what about biotin topical? Topically and putting biotin in your hair versus orally drinking it or eating it and putting it on your skin. Well, for me digging and researching and looking up, you know, I did not find anything that shows putting biotin topically on your skin or hair could help promote hair growth. However, there is a however. There is not a study that shows it doesn't work either. So it's kind of one of those things that is just up in the air. And people don't really know, or there is not enough studies going on that shows that biotin added or used topically can help promote hair growth or not. So it's one of those things, like, you can try it. If it does work, great. If it don't work, you know, there's not a scientific study behind it. Which biotin is inside, and biotin oil or topical oil for biotin is inside this growth oil in the bearded pup. Second, we're going to talk about pure organic black castor oil, Jamaican castor oil, which you guys know has been around for ages and ages and ages. And when you usually ask a barber, hey, what can I use to grow my beard? Oh, won't you use Jamaican castor oil, because that helps. You know, it's been proven, it's been around for ages, that it shows that it helps promote hair growth. You know, it stimulates your hair follicles, it stimulates blood flow. So that's a trusted source right there that you can find in this growth oil right here. Next, we're going to talk about sage. Now, sage oil, essential oil, it helps promote blood flow. So when you're putting this oil, massaging it on your beard, which keep in mind, when you're massaging that area as well, you are promoting blood flow to that area. So you're adding an oil, an essential oil, which is sage, which is known to help promote blood flow as well. So you're adding it to an area where you are making, where you're already massaging it in your skin. And when you're massaging, when you're exfoliating your skin, that's generating blood flow. So this just adds a little bit extra blood flow from the sage. Next is something that you typically find in regular beard oils, and that is the lavender essential oil. Studies show that it promotes hair growth, but its study was shown or done on mice. So no studies have been shown or that I could find that it was done on humans. But when they put the lavender essential oil on mice, it showed that their hair grew quicker and stronger as well. So it's one of those things, again, that you can put it on your body or your, not your body. Don't put it on your body, guys. This oil is not made for your private part. So kids, just wait until you hit puberty. This is not for that. This is for your facial hair. So lavender, it's one of those things that once you put it on your beard or put it on your hair, or put it on your skin, it's a hit or miss. It's like there's not any kind of studies that are done on humans, but that shows faster hair growth or anything like that. But it was done on mice, which, you know, most scientists use animals or rodents like mice for studies versus humans, which whatever. So that lavender is found on here. And then lavender is also put in most of our beard products, especially if you like a calming scent, you know, you find lavender in it. Last but not least, we're going to talk about the rosemary essential oil. Now, rosemary essential oil is known to help promote hair growth. Also, it helps increase blood flow. Patients that have the male pattern baldness, you know, when you're like, you know, using, you haven't, like, I have it right here, which I haven't put this on my head or anything like that, but, you know, the male pattern baldness, you know, people that can't handle minoxidil because it burns or anything like that, they have, or I guess you can say for a home remedy, they've been using rosemary, which there's been scientific proof, and there's been a lot of trending topics about rosemary that's happened in the past few years, how it helps prevent hair loss and promote, you know, hair growth as well, which that's another thing that you can find in this growth oil right here. Now, can this oil by itself make someone that is baby-faced go from, you know, 0 to 100 real quick? I don't know, you know, probably not, you know, and it probably, yes, I don't know. Like I haven't gave this to anybody that does not have a beard or can't grow a beard and say, here, you know, try this and see what you think about it. I can only go based on the experience that I have. Now, you know, recently you guys know that I've been on a weight loss kick. So, but when I say weight loss kick, it's like, I'm not doing anything strenuous or anything like that. I'm not going to exercising at the gym. You ain't gonna find me at the gym exercising. Let me tell you guys something. If you see me running, you better run right behind me, because there's something behind me that I can't take down, or I can't, you know, I can't take on my own. So I'm running for my life. You should be running with me too. Just so you know, you ain't gonna see me running, and you probably won't see me exercising anytime soon. I just don't do that. So, but I did start eating more protein as well, which, you know, that boosts testosterone a little bit. And then I've been drinking a lot more water, which water just keeps you hydrated and such. That's the only thing that I've been doing different with my diet. As far as, you know, doing anything as exercising that also helps boost more testosterone, anything like that, no, I have not. You know, and then I trimmed my beard almost to a buzz cut, and then I used this beard oil, which again, I used it for 6 weeks, a little bit over 6 weeks, and I tried to use it for almost every night. I used it at nighttime routine. When I first tried this beard oil, the growth oil, I was like, okay, well, you know, it tingles a little bit, which to me, that made it seem like it was working. And I just kept using it. And there were some nights that I'd forget to wear it. You know, I ain't gonna lie and say I've used it every single day, because there was like maybe 3 or 4 days that I forgot. And I would apply beard butter, stuff like that. But for the most part, for 6 weeks or a little bit over 6 weeks, I did use this oil. And I did notice that my beard was growing quicker. Again, the biotin, I can't speak on that behalf because it's, you know, it's in this oil. So there's something in this oil that does help with beard growth. Now, when I did read online, it said that biotin topically inserted or put in your beard can, or in your hair, can give you like an illusion of your beard being a little bit thicker. But obviously, this is an illusion. This is a real deal, Holyfield right here. So my advice to you guys is, you know, does beard oil or growth oil work? From most of the products that I see out there that I have not tried, I can't speak on those behalf. With the Bearded Pup, I cannot say that it didn't work, and I can't say that it didn't help with my growth, with my beard journey in the past 6 weeks, because I did notice that my beard is growing a lot quicker. And then some of you guys have also commented on my Instagram when seeing my pictures, or me just going live or making a video saying, damn, dude, your beard is growing super quick. And some of you guys, you know, that follow me on there knew that I was using this oil. So I cannot say that it doesn't work. I can go by what it did for me, and I can say that it helped a good bit with my my beard journey as far as growing. So if you guys want to try it out, you know, it's a hit or miss. It may work for you, may not. And you may be lacking the nutrients or the blood flow that's going towards your face. And this can, you know, with some of the essential oils and the ingredients in this oil, it can probably help stimulate that. You know, just like if you are lacking testosterone in your body and you're a male, you know, they make medicine for that, or they tell you to go exercise, you know, to see if that helps as before they give you on like test boosters or anything like that. So you may be lacking the blood flow that's going towards your face. And, you know, these right here could possibly help you as far as get the blood flow to your face. So, you know, I'm saying that I can only go by what it done for me, and I can say that I cannot say that it didn't work. So, but I can say that it did help in my opinion, in my experience. I think that it really did help as far as giving me a jump start or a boost as far as helping with my beard journey. If you are interested in trying the growth oil, you know, to see if it works for you. If it don't work for you, I'll put the link of the Bearded Pup on the in the bottom below so you guys can get you some and try it. He also has some great scents out there as well for his, you know, regular oils. Biker Blend is the one that I recommend the most. That's my favorite. He's got an oud that's really, really good too. Homewrecker I have not tried, so I can't say if it's good or not, but that is on my list as well. If you guys want to try the growth oil or any of his products, you can use the code SHARK15, capital SHARK, S-H-A-R-K, 15 to get 15% off your order. But that's all I got for you guys today, folks. So if you have any comments, questions, concern, drop them in the comment box below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you don't like this video, give me a thumbs down. But until next time, you guys already know, stay bearded. Duh.